on Pestalozzi alumni, successful in one particular university. The name Pestalozzi is spread around as students of note and worthy students.
The most important thing that we can give the developing world isn't handouts or aid, but it is education and skills and also ambition and aspiration. You know, I see the students that come here and they are phenomenally bright, and we're just giving them that extra bit of encouragement that will enable them to go on to the universities. My goodness, they do well. I mean, if you look at the universities that they go on to from here, you know, they are world-class universities.
I hope to work in one of these NGOs, maybe World Health Organization or UNESCO, because I really want to contribute to the public health sector of my country.
I would definitely prefer working in a developing country rather than a developed country, because I feel that's where they need civil engineers more.
My ambition is to study medicine and go home and contribute to the healthcare system.
I want to go and study food science and technology, so that when I go back home, I want to go into the food sector or the agricultural sector.
In long term, I want to be an hydraulics and water management engineer, because in India, there's a place, Cherrapunji, where the average rainfall is 1100 centimeter, but still there are droughts.
I think it's important that we double the number of students. We have the infrastructure, we have the staffing, we have the site, we have the opportunity, not just to double the number of students, but to extend the number of countries and communities that we offer this scholarship to. The site, sadly, as you can see, is 50 years old. It's looking rather ragged, but it's just as important that the site is a cultural development as much as a development simply of buildings. So one of the most exciting things that's happened at Pestalozzi recently is our link with the World Wildlife Fund and the opportunity to develop this site as a carbon zero site, so it becomes demonstrably educational as well as a practical site to live on.
What we're hoping to do here at the Pestalozzi site is something that's quite unique. It's going to be a village, a campus, a conference centre, an exhibition place, but a place where we can bring people to see sustainability in action. That is so important, because if you really want people to change their lifestyles, if you want businesses to do things in a different way, if you want governments to legislate in a different way, they really need to be able to see and understand for themselves what it is that you're talking about, to see this vision in action. And it's so exciting to be able to do that with a partner like Pestalozzi, because Pestalozzi is an inspirational organisation. It's doing a really important job in helping to create a more sustainable future for the global community anyway. And so to link it in with the One Planet Living programme, it makes absolute perfect sense for an organisation like WWF.
It's not enough to say that what we do is worthy. It has to make a difference. It has to make a difference through the young people that come to Pestalozzi. I think we have evidence that that is the case, and I think it's really important that the sort of international development that's been tried by creating opportunities elsewhere in the world has not actually focused on what the youth, educated youth of that country, are going to provoke and promote from their own point of view.
There is a famous Chinese proverb which says, like, give a man fish and you feed him for a day, but teach a man to fish and you feed him for a lifetime. I've been given a passion and a view to help other people around me. So it's no more like giving me fish for the day. It's like teaching my whole community, teaching me to fish. And then I can go back into my community and help others, teach them to fish.
Here you'd find future leaders, and not only politically, but also in their various vocations, who would go back home and make a contribution to their countries. Yeah, because I feel that aid may work for a few, months or whatever, but education will last generations to come. Yeah.